Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go.
Here's a simple holiday gift. Let's turn mason jars into snow globes with some treats. You can use any miniatures for your snow globes. I used some presents and rewrapped them. I'm next going to use plastic ornament halves. I'm going to trim off the hanger. After doing so, I'm going to fill it in with my miniatures. I want them to float, so I'm not gluing them down, but you can. And then I'm just adding some snow. And after filling, I'm going to hot glue the edges. I'm then going to apply it to the mason jar, holding it tightly. For finishing touches, you can use ribbon and wrapping it all the way around. This is definitely a great keepsake and something that people will enjoy and love. You can fill with hot chocolate, gingerbread cookies, or anything homemade, and everyone will appreciate it.
Still waiting for your glow up? That doesn't mean your room has to wait too. Give your room the glow up it deserves with Glow Up LEDs. Plus, since you watch this amazing channel, there's a discount code in the description below. Join the Glow Getter fam today at glowupleds.com.
Walking in a winter wonderland.
Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. Vixen and Blitzen and all his reindeer pulling on the reins.
Walking in a winter wonderland.
It's the most wonderful time of the year, with the kids jingle belling.
Underneath the tree, you're here, where you should be. Snow is falling as the carols sing. It just wasn't the same, alone on Christmas Day.
Thank you. Step one, put icing around the rim of the glass.
Next, roll in sprinkles.
1/4 cup of Irish cream liquor. 1/2 cup of milk.
2 shots of vanilla vodka.
2 shots of amaretta.
Shake it.
Serve.
Woo woo! There you have it, sugar cookie martini.
Shrinkydings! Did you have any idea you could use a heat gun to shrink down Shrinkydings? We did.
This is a great last-minute Christmas activity.
All you have to do is use permanent marker on Shrinkyding paper, cut it out, and then use your heat gun.
We like to put it in a small box just so it doesn't fly away. It's gonna curl, bend, manipulate, but it will always lay flat in the end.
And then we just used some LED fairy lights and glued them on with hot glue. I think they look so cute.
So cute. To make a vintage little light bulb, Christmas light bulb.
I don't want a lot for Christmas. There is just one thing I need. I don't care about the presents underneath the Christmas tree. I just want you for my own.
Here's a tutorial how to make the Santa mat Anthropology inspired. I started off with this IKEA mat for $4.99, and then I rounded the edges. I'm going to be using painter's tape for a guide. Just like the ones I used to. Next, I'm going to brush a green color for the top of the hat. I'm going to dab it to get in the in-betweens. Then I'm going to work my way down for the hat. I'm going to brush white paint to finish the hat. Next, I'm going to be shaping the beard. I pretty much freehanded everything, but towards the middle, I started to regret it because I was going outside my lines. Just as a tip, you can use a Sharpie very lightly, a little bit lighter than what I was doing here, and just kind of get those shapes, and you can just scratch it off with a razor. Another tip, I noticed that my colors weren't going deep into the rug, so I grabbed a rag and just started spreading it, and this worked really well. So if you want to do that versus a paintbrush, it might be a little bit easier. Hopefully that helped. I'll post more tips on my Instagram.
That's right. This is the candy cane tie-dye. One of you suggested we do this. We did it. We love the idea. Candy canes are awesome. Everybody loves a cane of candy. What I need is more ideas for Christmas tie-dyes. If you could, in the comments, let me know what you guys are thinking. I'd love to do them. Thanks for watching. Peace out, guys.